Welcome to the today's session. Today we are going to discuss about asymmetric cryptography and key generation in the unit 3. Today we are going to start. That is the title of the unit 3, asymmetric cryptography. So far we have seen symmetric cryptography, that is both ends at the receiver side and sender side, both sides we are using the same key for the encryption and decryption as well. But in the encryption or decryption, in a symmetric cryptography, the problem is sharing of the keys and verifying the signature, because on both sides we have to use the same key. It means it has to be distributed at both the ends. If sender creates a key, it has to be sent to the receiver, and similarly if the other end creates the key, the same key has to be distributed through the network. So in that process, if any attacker finds that or attacks the key, then they can easily get the data. Okay, that is the problem, right? So in an asymmetric, see that at both the ends, at the sender or receiver side, at both the ends the keys are different. Okay, so that problem can be solved. So let us see public key cryptography principles. The first topic, the public key cryptography principles. See the public key cryptography. See, the development of this public key cryptography is the greatest true revolution in the entire history of the cryptography. So when they introduced this public key cryptography, it is really, they made a great revolution in the history of cryptography. It is asymmetric, means the use of two separate keys. Actually, in a symmetric, I told you, they use the same key, but in asymmetric, they use the different keys for encryption and decryption process. The public key schemes are less secure compared to the private key. If you compare both the public key and private key, the public key is less secure than the private key. So in a public key cryptography, the complements, rather than replacing the cryptography, both have the same issues, that key distribution. Okay, what is the problem? Key distribution. In a public key also, it is open. So how to secure the keys are the problem. Okay, it requires the use of, and also they are required the suitable protocols, and they need to share the key between the network. That is the issue. See, the concept of this public key cryptography evolved from an attempt to attack two of the most difficult problems. What are those problems? One is key distribution and another one is digital signature. So how to have the secure communication in general? So if we doesn't know any, if there is no trusted KDC, okay, the key distribution channel, KDC means key distribution channel. If you don't know the key distribution channel, proper trusted key distribution channel, and definitely it is difficult to share the keys between the ends. The digital signature is, we need to verify. Then how to verify a message comes intact from the claimed sender? Say for example, some other person, not the authenticated sender, some other person has copied and they have sent the request. And there, how we can verify that? it is not the original, it is not a message sent by the original sender. So these are the two most difficult problems associated with the symmetric encryption. Okay, see here, the public key or two key or asymmetric cryptography involves the use of two keys. Okay, it may be public key or two key or asymmetric key. So how that problem is overcome here? See, the public key, which may known by anybody, public means it is open to all and can be used to encrypt message. What it do? The public key do that, it will encrypt the message and verify the signatures. What it do? What is the operation of this public key? Encrypt messages and verify the signatures. That is a part of public key. That public key is known to anybody. What about private key? It is known to the only recipient. Only the receiver knows that private key, and it used to decrypt. What it do? It decrypt the message and sign signatures, and will create the signatures. So what is the operation of public key? It will encrypt and verify the signature. The operation of private key, they decrypt and create the signatures. Okay, so these two are used in a public key or an asymmetric or two key cryptography algorithm. So is a symmetric because those who encrypt the message or verify signature cannot decrypt the message or create the signature. So here you can see, though the public key is open to all, it is having by all the people, because we say that public key is known by anybody. Maybe it is known, but you can observe here, just they can encrypt the message and verify the signatures. They cannot decrypt the message or they cannot create the signatures. Because of that, they cannot get the original text, the original content they cannot find. Okay, see, we have this figure, encryption figure. For that, this figure illustrates public key encryption process. We will see how the public key encryption will perform, and shows that a public key encryption scheme has a 6 ingredients. We have 6 ingredients totally, that is plain text, encryption algorithm, public key, private key, ciphertext, decryption algorithm. Okay, let us see, let us observe the diagram here. Just go through once. So this is an encryption part, encryption message that you can observe here. See what you observe, it is a plain text input. So here, public key ring, there are multiple users. You can observe Joy, Mike, Alice, Ted, Bob. So like that, we have different users. See here, this plain text input is given to the encryption algorithm. So let's say, for example, it is an RSA algorithm. Okay, so what we are doing here, we are taking the public key of Alice. In this process, the pair of keys are generated. What is the pair of keys means? See here, the Alice is generated the public key. Okay, what we do this, with a public key, we can perform the encryption. See here, by using the RSA algorithm, with the Alice public key, we are performing the encryption process. So after that, so it is converted into as a ciphertext. Okay, So this ciphertext will be moved through the network. The transmitted ciphertext. Okay, you can observe here when you are encrypting the data with the Alice public key, to decrypt you need Alice private key. So that is a pair. So if you try to decrypt with any other private key, say for example Bob's private key, or you may use Joy's private key, or you may use Mike's private key, it will not allow you to perform the decryption process, because in the encryption they were used Alice public key. So to make or to perform the decryption, definitely you have to apply the Alice private key only. So if you use Alice private key, it will decrypt the algorithm, okay, and finally you will get the plain text. So this is what this public key encryption process. So this is the public key encryption process. So finally it was encrypted and sent through the network, and it was received at the receiver side. It performed the decryption process with the same key, but it is a private, okay, and we'll get the original plain text output. Okay, now so what are the steps involved in the public key encryption scheme? So just now we have discussed the public key encryption. See, what are the steps involved here? See, every user or each user should generate a pair of keys. These keys are used for what? These keys are used for encryption and decryption process. So we will be generating the pair of keys which are used for the encryption and decryption. Okay, so each user places one of the two keys in a public register and other key in a private register. So we are generating the pair of keys. Pair means two. So after that, what we need to do? We need to place one key in a public register and another key in a private register. Okay. So public key encryption principles. So the first two steps we have seen. One is pair of keys, generating the pair of keys. One is for encryption, another one is decryption. And here, so each user places in a pair the one key in a private register and another one is in public register. Okay. See the third step. Say for example, B wants to send a confidential message to A. See here, A, B. B wants to send a confidential message to A. Okay. So the B encrypts the message using what? Now the B wants to send the message to, confidential message to A. Then what it has to perform? It has to perform the encryption. B has to perform the encryption. So encryption by using what key? It has to use what? It has to use the public key. It has to use the public key of A. So whenever this B encrypt the message with a public key of A, after that it will be sent to the, it will be transmitted through the network to the A. Then what will perform? A knows his private key. It will decrypt that message. It will decrypt that message, and it will decrypt the message with what? With a private key. With the private key of A, then it will get the original message. Will get the original message. So that is the process. If any, say in this example, the B wants to send the confidential message to A, then he has to follow this. See what is happening when A receives the message. She decrypts it using her private key. Okay. Okay, so nobody else can decrypt the message, because that can only be done using A's private key, because you have done the encryption with the A's public key. So it is possible to open that only with the A's private key. That is the reason. So though you may have any other private keys, B, C, D, E, F, for example, you cannot decrypt, or you cannot get the original content. Okay, and see the fifth step. If a user wishes to change his keys, generate another pair of keys and publish the public one, no interaction with other users is needed. So what we do, if we want to change the keys, then we can generate a pair of keys, and one key can be published in a public, it can be open to anybody, but no interaction with other users is needed. So we don't need to interact with anybody. Just what we do, just we will create the pair, and one key will be given in a public and another is private. So we can't share that private key. Okay. See, some notations we need to understand in this public key cryptography. See, for example, public key of user A. Public key of user A will be performing KUA. Public key. Okay. So the private key of user A, it is represented with KRA. Okay, when it is public key, you are using U. When it is private key, you are using R. And this A, B, this A will be changed based on the situation, right? The encryption method, we represent with a capital E. Similarly, the decryption is represented with the capital D. Okay. Let us see that if B wishes to send a plain message X to A, then it will be sent like this. Okay. What we have to do? B wishes to send a plain message X to A. A is there. B is there. B wishes to send a message to A. So then what it has to perform? B, what to do? It has to perform the encryption. Okay, encryption of what? By using KUA, comma, what is the message? Say for example, our message is represented with X. So this is what the representation, encryption of KUA comma X. That original plain message, you are performing the encryption with KUA. What is a KUA? It is a public key of A. So that you are performing here. So Y is equal to E of KUA comma X. So now you are sending the A to the, now you are sending the Y to the A. See, the receiver A, what it will do? It will receive that, it will decrypt the message. What it has to perform? decryption. Decryption is denoted with capital D. So what this A has to do? The A has to do that KRA. What is KRA? Private key of A. It has to perform the decryption by using the private key of A, comma, Y. What is this Y? This one, the received message. So after performing the decryption process using decryption with a private key of A, okay, we will get the original plain text X, right? See here, if there is an attack on public key encryption, then that attack on authentication. See, attacker may copy user B. He sends a message E of KUA comma X and claims in the message to B minus A has no guarantee to this so. Because what it has to do? What is happening here? See here, public key cryptography is the attack and authentication. An attacker may impersonate, means he may copy user B. He copied the user B and he will send a message to the A. Then there is no guarantee to this. So then what we need to do? To overcome this, what the B will encrypt the message using his private key. What it do? Actually, previous what I told you, it will do the encryption with the public key of A. And B wants to send a message to A, it has to perform the encryption with the public key of A. But here, if any attacker, if any attacker copies that B, then there is a problem. To overcome that, B will encrypt the message using his private key. Okay, Y is equal to E of KRB comma X. So before I have told you to encrypt with a public key, but here now we are using the private key. See, then what the receiver has to do? The receiver decrypts using B's public key. So reverse. So when it is encrypted and sends to B, then it has to use the public key. Okay. So here we have the authenticity of the sender because he is the only one who knows the private key. Atrak matrame telusu. Only he knows, not to the others. So this entire encrypted message serves as a digital signature. This scheme is shown in the following figure. Let us see this. Okay. The simple. See here, Bob's private key. We are using the private key for performing the encryption. And then we are transmitting the data. So with the Bob's public key, the decryption will be done. And finally, we will get the plain text output. Just we have performed the reverse here. Earlier, we were done public key at the sender side. Now we are performing the private key. So when you are performing the private key here, definitely automatically you have to perform the public key at the receiver side. Okay. Okay, so but a drawback still exists. Anybody can decrypt the message using B's public key because anybody can decrypt the message using B's public key. So secrecy or confidentiality is missing. Secrecy or confidentiality is missing. So one can provide the both authentication and confidentiality. So here you have to observe that in one way we are missing the authentication, or we are missing the confidentiality. So far what we were discussed, I will tell you. Say for example A, B. Okay, so what I told you, if the B wants to send a message to A, what it is performing? It is performing the encryption of with a public key of A. Say for example X is the plain text. Okay, this is one case. Now you are using the public key, then you are sending the data to A. So here the decryption will be done. But if any attacker has copied this, then there is a problem. So what is the problem? What we are missing there? There we are missing the authentication. Here we are missing the authentication. What is the another case? Just now we were seeing in another case. See that. Okay, now the B wants to send a message to A. Now what we are performing? So to send, we have to perform the encryption. We are performing the encryption with KR of A. KR of A. It means you are performing this with a private key of A. When you are performing the private key of A, what it has to be done? When you send a message to A, the A has to perform the decryption. He has to perform the decryption with what? Public key. With the public key of A. So what is happening here? Some security is missing because it is a open. Okay? It is a public, so anybody can do this. If the others do this, what happens? We lose our confidentiality. So in the first case, we are losing the authentication. In the second case, we are losing the confidentiality. So to overcome the problem, to maintain both, what we need to perform? See this. See the message source X. It is performed the encryption algorithm with some key. Okay, KR means a private key. See, again you are performing the encryption with a public key. See here, it is a KR of A. Okay, and it is KU of B. So it is a private key of A, it is a public key of B. See, when you are using the public key of B, what you have to use at the receiver side? Reverse, the public key of B, here you have to use the private key of B. Here you have to use the private key of B. And then here you have used private key of A. And then here you have to use what? Public key of A. Is it clear? So now what we are doing, we are performing this encryption and decryption more than one time. So one is with the private key and another one is with the public key. So in this case, this crypto system is maintaining both the authentication and security. So here it is maintaining both authentication and security. So these are the representations. When it encrypts the X with a private key, will give like this. So this is what about public key cryptography. Okay, how it will be done